Hello my dear students, welcome to the next lecture in analog electronics. We have already discussed the BJT configuration and its characteristics. We saw how to fix the operating point after drawing DC load line. Then we discussed about different biasing circuits, the requirement of biasing circuits, relative advantages and disadvantages of different biasing circuits. And then we concluded that voltage divider bias circuit is the most widely used one, and we derived the stability factor for voltage divider bias circuit, and we also discussed about different compensation techniques. And in the last lecture we discussed about small signal amplifier. We are continuing our discussion. We have completed the graphical method of analyzing the performance of an amplifier, and in this lecture we are going to see the equivalent circuit analysis of amplifier circuit. So let us discuss about equivalent circuit method. So to determine the AC behavior of the amplifier circuit, we have to consider this AC equivalent circuit. Here you can see the capacitor, the input, the coupling capacitors are shorted, as well as the emitter side, the capacitor is also considered to be shorted for AC input. Then in this method, the transistor is also replaced by its AC equivalent. So let us see how to find the AC equivalent of this transistor. So in order to develop the AC equivalent circuit of a BJT in common emitter configuration, first let's see the typical output characteristics of a BJT in common emitter configuration. You are all familiar with this curve. You can see that the variation in IC for a change in VCE is very small. That is, keeping IB constant for a particular base current, this is base current, the change in IC corresponding to change in VCE is very small. This means that the output section of the BJT offers very high dynamic resistance. That is, the output resistance delta VCE by delta IC changes very small. So since this denominator is small, the output resistance is very high. So this is offering a very high dynamic resistance. So the transistor can be replaced by a current source between its output terminals. You can see this R0 is representing the dynamic output resistance of the transistor. Its value is very high and it's in the range 40 kilo ohm. From the CARA we understood that it has a very high value, and therefore the output side is represented using this circuit. So what is this current source? This is the collector current IC. IC is equal to beta times IB. So you are replacing the transistor output side with this current source, which has a magnitude beta IB. So beta IB, you can note one thing, this is small signal AC analysis, that is why all the variables are represented using small letters. IC, VC, IB, etc. You can see they are indicated using small letters. Now we have to see the input side. For that, you know that the input characteristics is similar to a forward bias diode characteristics. So the base emitter junction can be replaced by a resistance with a low value, typically 800 ohm. So input resistance is very small. So this is the base current to the base. This VB is the base voltage and IB is the input current that is flowing into the transistor, and RI is the input resistance. Okay, so the base emitter junction is replaced using this, and this is the equivalent circuit for the input side. So finally, the transistor AC equivalent circuit can be formed by combining the input and output section. So the input section you have VB, IB and RI, and the output section you have a current source and a high output resistance, dynamic resistance. So that is connected in parallel. If you have a current source in parallel with a resistance R0. So this emitter is a common terminal. So combining the input and output section, you get the AC equivalent circuit of BJT in common emitter configuration. Next, we'll discuss the H parameter equivalent circuit of BJT. So H stands for hybrid. Why you are going to develop the equivalent circuit using hybrid parameters? So if you go through the data sheets of transistors, you will see the characteristics of transistor in terms of its H parameters. Okay, so why is this word hybrid used? Because these parameters are a mixture of different constants having different units. We'll see that, and these parameters can be measured very easily. So this BJT is a three terminal device with one terminal common to both input and output, and that is the emitter terminal. So the input terminal and output terminal will have two variables, that is current and input current and voltage variable, and output current and voltage variables. So for each pair of terminals there are two variables. So with that we are going to represent the hybrid equivalent circuit. So you are considering this BJT as a two port network. So what is inside this? Inside this you have the BJT and you have just taken the terminals outside. So this is the common terminal. 3 represents the emitter, 2 represents the collector, and 1 represents the base. So when you consider this BJT as a two port network, you will see that V1 is the input voltage and I1 is the input current, and V2 is the output voltage and I2 is the output current. So you can represent any network. This is, we are considering BJT, we are representing a two port network using its H parameters. So these are some parameters with different units. So V1 can be represented as some parameter H11 into I1 plus the output voltage V2. Similarly, I2 can be represented as H21 I1 plus H22 V2. That is, the same variables are used here, I1 and V2. Okay. Now, the H parameters can be defined as follows. From the previous equation, you can find out the values of H11, H21, H12 and H22. Please observe this. What is H11? This H11 will be equal to V1 by I1 if V2 equal to 0. Similarly, H12 will be equal to V1 by V2 if I1 equal to 0. So that is how the H parameters are defined. So H11 is equal to V1 by I1 for V2 equal to 0. And you can see that it is the ratio of input voltage to input current. So it is nothing but the input impedance with the output shorted. V2 equal to 0 means output is shorted. And this is indicated as HI. I indicating input impedance. Okay. Then H21 is equal to I2 by I1 for V2 equal to 0. That is from the second equation. That is H21 is equal to I2 by I1 for V2 equal to 0 when output is shorted. So that is written here, I2 by I1 for V2 equal to 0. So what is this? The ratio of two currents, I2 by I1. So it is an output current by input current. So it is a forward current ratio with output shorted. Since it is forward current ratio, it is HF. Okay. Now what is H12? We have already discussed. It is equal to V1 by V2 for I1 equal to 0. That is with input open. When I1 equal to 0, the reverse voltage ratio. Why reverse? It is a ratio of V1 to V2. Input to output. So it is reverse voltage ratio and it is indicated by HR. And what is H22? It is I2 by V2. It is a ratio of current to voltage. So it is the opposite of impedance. What is the opposite of impedance? It is admittance. And it is a output side parameters I2 and V2 for I1 equal to 0. So here you get output admittance with input open. So it is indicated by HO. So input HI, input impedance, forward current ratio, since it is for F, HF, and reverse voltage ratio, V1 by V2 with input open, so it is HR, and H22 equal to I2 by V2 or output admittance with input open, that is H0. Now, since the BJT is in common emitter mode, we are adding an additional suffix E to the symbols of H parameters. So how will the equation which we just wrote down using the 1 and 2 terminals, it will get modified? That is, V1 is VB, nothing but the input base voltage, that is base voltage VB, isn't it? So VB is equal to, this is HI and you have added the E here indicating common emitter. So HIE, I1 is IB plus HRE VC, VC is V2, HRE. Then IC equal to HFE IB plus HOE VC. Okay. So you can draw the hybrid input equivalent circuit from these equations. What are the equations you have? At the input side, you have VB equal to HIEIB plus HREVC. So how will you draw the input equivalent circuit? This is simple Kirchhoff's voltage law. So here you see you have VB as a voltage source and this is the base terminal, this is the emitter terminal. So here you are representing this as HIE. So it is equal to HIEIB. So you are representing this by an impedance HIE with value HIE plus you have another voltage, that is HREVC. This is unitless. HRE is unitless, then it is a ratio of V1 to V2. Okay, so this is how you represent the input equivalent circuit. What about the output equivalent circuit? For output equivalent circuit, you have IC equal to HFEIB plus HOEVC. So IC equal to HFEIB plus HOEVC. So here it is current equation. So you have to apply Kirchhoff's current law here. So this IC equal to HOEVC. VC is the output voltage. What is the voltage across this? It is VC. So what is the current through this? It is HOEVC. HOE is admittance. Okay. HOEVC. This is admittance and plus this current source. You know the output circuit is represented using a current source. So HFEIB. So combining the hybrid input equivalent circuit and output equivalent circuit, you can develop the complete equivalent circuit of BJT using H parameters in common emitter mode. So input side you have VB, IB, then HIE, HREVC, and at the output side you have VC, IC, HOE and HFEIB. So this is the complete equivalent circuit of BJT using H parameters. Now comparing the H parameter equivalent model with the AC equivalent model which we have just developed, you can see that HIE is equal to RI. This is evident from this figure. HIE is same as the RI which you have drawn. That is the dynamic input resistance. HFE is equal to beta. See, you have the HFEIB here. Isn't it? So this is HFE is beta. HFE is beta. And 1 by HOE is equal to R naught. Since this is admittance, 1 by HOE equal to R naught, the dynamic output resistance. You can note one thing. The only difference is this. What is the only difference from the previous circuit? You have this source HREVC when you consider the H parameter equivalent. Isn't it? So that is depending on the output voltage VC. Okay. So the parameter HRE is representing a feedback from VC. A feedback of the output voltage to the input circuit. Isn't it? So in the input section you have this. In the input section you can see this. So in the normal operation of transistor, this effect is very small. And this, if you neglect this term, HREVC, there is no significant effect practically. Okay, so the typical values, if you observe, you can conclude that point also. HIE is 1 kilo ohm, that is the, or 800 ohm, we have said the, for the input dynamic input resistance. So closer values, so, to 800 ohm, it is 1 kilo ohm. And you see HFE is 50, that is beta, you can have 50 or any values. Then HRE, you see this, it has a power of 10 raised to minus 4, which means it can be neglected. HRE. So HOE is equal to 25 microsiemens. This is the admittance HOE. So the output impedance is 1 by HOE. And you know its typical value is 40 kilo ohm, very high output dynamic resistance. Okay. So with this, I am ending the discussion on H parameter equivalent circuit of BJT. In the upcoming lecture, we will develop the AC equivalent circuit of an amplifier, considering this H parameter equivalent circuit of BJT into that. Thank you.